Hi, I'm Tamara Berg, and today we're learning our ATCs. For those of you who don't already know, ATC is short for Artist Trading Card. They're miniature works of art that are created and traded by everyone from quilters to crafters to artists of all kinds. Well, the only way you can get an ATC is by giving an ATC. So we're going to start your collection today and make your ATC. This is the artist trading card we're going to be making today. From as early as the 1600s, artists made miniatures of their art for sale and for promotion. Well, artist trading cards don't have anything to do with sale. They're merely art for art's sake, as well as the activity of trading them. Kind of like trading Olympic pins or baseball trading cards. First, we're going to go over the very few but very important rules about ATCs, the ABCs of ATCs. A, they are always 2.5 inches by 3.5 inches. B, they are never sold, they are always traded. And C, they usually have contact information on the back. Okay, so we're starting our ATC with an 8.5 by 11 piece of cardstock, and I did some measurements and figured out a cut sheet to make it really easy so that you can maximize the 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. And here it is. So what you're gonna do is cut a 2.5 inch strip long ways and another 2.5 inch strip long ways, and then your third strip will be 3.5 inches. See where I'm going with this? You take your long 2.5 inch strip, cut that at 3.5 inch increments, and you'll have just this much waste. So do that with both of your 2.5 inch strips, and then on your third strip, you'll cut at 2.5 inch increments and have this much waste. That way you get 10 cards out of one 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. Okay, so let's get started with our card. I'm using a rubber stamp as the main image of this ATC, and here it is. It's a pretty lady, and it happens that this stamp is 2 inches by 3 inches, so it works perfectly within the confines of the 2.5 by 3.5 dimensions of an ATC. I put the stamp on a piece of linen paper, and I really liked using the linen because it added some extra texture within this card and also made it look a little bit like she's on canvas. So I stamped her on the card and then cut it out. It's easier to do that than to try and position your stamp on a tiny little piece of paper. So now she needs a little bit of embellishment. And I'm using the Just Glitter pens from Marvy, Uchida in the gold glitter. And we're taking her to the beauty salon. She's gonna get some highlights. So I'm just gonna draw on some curly cues and give her some little ringlets. Who knew I could do hair too? Looks totally natural, don't you think? Okay, so we're gonna give her some little ringlets here. And you can layer these glitter pens to get more glitterosity on the paper. And then we're also gonna do just a little frame around her. So now she needs some jewelry. Now, you may know me from Plum and Verdigris. You do know that I make jewelry as well as being a crafter. And you may also know that I really like working with wire. And if you don't know me from Plum and Verdigris, why not? You should be watching that show too. Okay, so I like to work with wire, and I've got a 3-inch piece of wire here that's just copper from the hardware store. And I'm gonna make a really cool embellishment with this. For this, I'm gonna use the Marvy Uchida Wave Corrugator, and I'm just gonna put my wire right through this. Now, the important thing with this is you do have to hold the wire perpendicular to the corrugator. If it goes sideways, your corrugations in the wire will get a little wonky. That's tech talk. And you want them to be even and straight. So I'm just kind of guiding it through. Hey, where do you think you're going there, mister? And look what happens. We get a piece of wire with these perfect little rick-rack corrugations. Now this wire was 3.5 to 4 inches when I started. I'm gonna cut it down to 1.5 inches. You might wonder why I'm using a long piece to start with, and it's just because putting it through that corrugator, it's easier to hold it in place when it's longer and then to cut it down to the length that you need. So here we go, right about 1.5 inches. And then I'm just gonna take that and with my fingers, make just a little loop on here and bring the two ends to the top. Now, we're going to add a bead to this, and my bead is pretty big, but the hole on this bead is not quite large enough for two widths of the wire to go through. If your hole on your bead is wide enough, then put both ends through the bead hole. I'm just going to put the front end through, and then I'm looping the back end around on the back. So just get that all in place, and then we're just going to put a little white glue on the end of the wire right here, the part that's going to go into the bead. Place that on. And then I'm just going to put another little dab of glue right on the back of the bead, because that's where we're going to attach it. And then we're just going to place that right where her ear would be. And then we're going to set that aside. After all the trauma of getting her hair done and her makeup and her jewelry, she needs a nap. So we're going to set her aside and let her nap a little bit. This is the purple card that we cut in the beginning, and that's going to be the base of this ATC. And we're going to put a frame around her with this. So I'm just going to use the tinted embossing pad from Marvy, Uchida, and I'm just going to run the edge along this pad and get it inked up. So we're going to add a little bit of gold embossing powder on here. So we're just going to melt this up. Just get that last part melted. And little part right here. Okay, we're all set. Now we're going to add the signature on the back of this card. And I'm going to be using a Puffy Velvet marker from Marvy Uchida for this, because again, we're doing a lot of texture layers on this card. So I'm going to write my name and my contact information. And you can make artist trading cards in series, but this is a one of a kind, so I'm just gonna write one of one. If you were doing a series, say of 10 cards, you'd have one of 10, two of 10, three of 10, like that. But this is a one of a kind. And then we're using the heat tool again to activate the Puffy Velvet markers. Where the Puffy Velvet marker is a little bit wetter, it will really puff up, or where it's more dry, it'll just get kind of a matte velvety finish. So here we go. And see how the color changes a little bit when it's puffed as well. So we've got that all set. So we're going to add another element to this of texture as well as color, and I'm using a heavy duty piece of brass foil. I've cut this piece to 2 1/4 inches by 3 1/2, and I've made it the entire 3 1/2 because as we put it through the paper corrugator, it will shrink a little bit. So I'm just going to lay that in the corrugator and run it right through. Wait till you see how this comes out. It looks so fabulous. See how cool that is? Now, because foil really holds its shape, you get some really crisp waves. So now we are ready to assemble our card. We've got our base card with the embossed glitter edge and the signature on the back with the Puffy Velvet markers. Then we have the foil piece, and you'll notice, see, it is a little bit smaller than the 3 1/2 inches of the card. And then we've got our pretty lady all ready to go out for the evening. So I've put some heavy duty double-sided adhesive tape on the back of these, and that really works well for the foil because it's got all that texture in it. So I'm putting that one down nice and tight, and then our lady all dressed up for the evening. She is ready to go, and just attach her in the center. So here we have our finished artist trading card. She's pretty, all decked out and ready to go. Maybe she will meet some friends this evening. So I'm going to show you some other artist trading cards that I've made and received, and some of them use the same techniques we've used today. I've made a friend for our pretty lady. She's a little blue though. I hope she has fun at the party. As you can see, I've made some curly cues that are just free form out of copper wire, and then put silver wire in different gauges through the corrugator, as well as a piece of foil to add some different elements to this card. Then I also used the corrugator and ran a piece of foil that was originally a rectangle, but I ran it through on the diagonal, and so it stretched out the rectangle a little bit so it became a rhombus. Everybody remember that from 10th grade math? And then I used the Puffy Velvet markers to accentuate the waves in the foil and puffed them up, and then we've got a nice beaded accent. I've also got some cards here that I have received in trades, and I snuck over to the other room and I found this ATC card holder that Trisha made in Expanding Memories. And as you get to trading, you're gonna need one of these too. So get out there, get trading, get creating, and make something beautiful. I'll see you next time.
For step-by-step instructions on how to create this week's project, download the design guide featuring special Make It Your Own bonus tips.